Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Sports Today. My name is Ridhima Pathak, and today is a very special day because all of you join us on this particular video, ask your questions to our expert, who is Deep Das Gupta, who will join me in a second. And then, of course, your questions will be answered by him. But before that, let's take a look at what How's That app has in store for us.
क्या आप भी किसी अपने सपने मेरे तुम्हारे टीम 11 पे टीम बना रहे हो और बच्चों के साथ खेल रहे हो? हमारे साथ खेलोगे? हाउस ऐप पे खेलो लेजेंड्स के साथ, हमें हरा और जीतो डबल कैश। लॉग ऑन टू houseapp.com एंड विन रियल कैश।
Talking about that, the first test is wrapped up. England win by 227 runs in Anderson. Let me tell you, is a player who is somewhere, somehow, anywhere present. And that's the reason why the man has stolen the show away from India. But of course, feel free to ask in your questions. I'm joined by Deep Das Gupta. Good evening, sir.
Good evening. How are you?
I am fantastic. How about yourself?
I can't complain. Chennai is good. I mean, apart from the result of the test match, otherwise it's fine. It's the usual bubble life, which you've gone through as well.
Yes. So tell me the impact of this particular game on the World Test Championship.
Obviously, this is a big hit. India had a little bit of an elbow room before the start of this test match. So now there is none whatsoever. So for India, I mean, India can't afford to lose any more test matches if it wants to qualify. At this point in time, obviously, India is number fourth and England is at the top right now. So this is where it stands. I mean, India needs to win at least two out of the next three and not lose at all. I mean, can afford a draw, but can't afford a loss anymore.
So if India do lose, how does it impact Australia's chances? What happens to the other team?
Yeah, I think along with England, I mean, England winning the test match, along with the English fans being happy, I think the Australian fans would be happy as well, because if this series ends in a draw, I think if ends in a 2-2 draw and a few more other permutation and combination, Australia goes through to the finals. So yeah, Australia is like very much in the race now.
All right. So we've got many questions coming in our comment section, because this particular show is all about our audience streaming questions with you. Also, we'll be joined by audience in a video chat. Anybody who's here, if you're on Twitter, you just have to click the StreamYard link that has been given on Twitter, and we've retweeted that. It's also on Sports Today's Twitter handle. And you just have to click that and join us on our video chat, and you can ask your question, and Deep Sir right here will take it. We've got a question here by Arin. If we are looking for bowlers who can bat, why are we also not looking for batsmen who can bowl 4-8 overs if needed, especially in limited overs cricket? Isn't it unfair on the bowlers?
No, fair enough. I think that's a fair question. But the only thing is, if you look at the top order batsmen and most of the top order batsmen, unfortunately, even the fringes, if I'm talking about, aren't batsmen who can bowl. I mean, if you go back a few years, you always had someone like a Yuvraj who was so good. Viru used to bowl. Even Rohit, start of his career, used to bowl. But at this point in time, I can't think of even the fringe players, fringe batsmen, I'm saying, and people who are on the fringes, batsmen. I don't see too many who can bowl, actually. Look at Prithvi, Mayank, Kale, Shreyas. I mean, none of them actually bowl. So, yeah, I mean, it's interesting. And I have a theory. I have a hypothesis why you don't find them anymore, but maybe for some other time.
Okay. All right. So, we joined by Vinay Dadicha. So, Vinay Dadicha is joining us on the chat right now. So, Vinay, if you are listening to us, you just need to turn on your video. Show us a beautiful face and join us in the show. We've got plenty of room today. Okay, he's not here now. he's just like, all right. We've got another question. We've got Ansh Khurana asking, do you think Akshar Patel and Kuldeep Yadav will get a chance to play in place of Washington Sundar and Shahbaz Nadeem?
Well, with how Shahbaz bowled in the last test match, I think there will be a replacement. Washington, I think, because Washington was played as more of a batsman who can bowl. somebody who can bat at number seven. And he did a wonderful job, especially in the first innings, the way he batted. So I don't find any reason why Washington should be replaced, unless it's a strategic call. So I do see a replacement, but then the question is then who? And both of them, I think, are quality choices. Axar obviously would have been your first choice, even in the first test match. Unfortunately, he was injured. He wasn't available because of injury. So Axar could be a very, very good choice. And so will Kuldeep. But I think Axar, because of, I think what a left-arm spinner, left-arm orthodox finger spinner, brings in more control. Maybe that's the reason he might be preferred. And it's a straight swap for Axar coming in place of Nadeem. It's like, you know, straight swap. I think one of them will replace. I don't see both of them. I don't find any reason why Washington should be. I see at least one of them replacing, and I guess Axar would be the choice.
All right. Here's another question. We've got Ansh Khurana asking, Vaibhavjan asking, thoughts on giving Bumrah, Ishan the rest to keep them fresh for the ping ball test, bringing in Siraj and Shardul?
Especially if you look at the number of overs that both of them bowled and how they bowled. I thought they were absolutely brilliant, Bumrah and Ishant. I think Bumrah bowled 36 overs in the first innings. Ishant also bowling around 30, 32, something on those lines. And also bowled their hearts out. Every ball they ran in hard, they put in everything. So, they would be tired. And mind you, it's only 3 days rest between the first and the second test. But Bumrah also, I think, had a fairly longish break before this test match because he didn't play the last test match in Australia. So there was a good 3+ weeks of rest. Ishant also playing after a very long time, actually. So I don't see, from that perspective, resting them. And also, there's a six-day gap between the second and the third. I don't think they'll be rested. And now, especially with India not winning the test match or rather losing the first test match, the pressure would be on the Indians. So, I don't think they'll go with... obviously, that both of them happens to be the first choice for the team management. And they did well also. It's not that they didn't. So I think, I think they'll go with the same, at least both of them.
Right. I see Virat Kohli and the boys stepping up in the next game, and they'll come all guns blazing also because the impact of this on the World Test Championship. Having said that, England also is not going to take it easy. I mean, I'm sure. Yeah. A whole generation that saw that particular test match thought to themselves, oh, wait, I can do that too. You know?
Yeah.
So we've got Jay Patel asking, we've got Tina Chhabra and Jay Patel. Okay, I'm sorry. They've just dropped out. I'm really sorry. Okay, there are plenty of chats coming in, guys. So you guys have to be really patient with us. We've got Parth Patel asking, is it tough to sweep, reverse sweep against wrist spinner if Kuldeep plays in the next match? You have to premeditate to play reverse sweep and he can spin both ways.
Yes, I think Kuldeep is a wicket-taking bowler. And we haven't really seen him bowl in a match situation, any format, right, in a while. I think IPL was the last time we saw him bowl. But I've seen him bowl in the nets or before the match or during the match because he's not playing. And I think he's bowling really well. He's a lot quicker in the air. There were some technical issues with his front arm, which he's working on. It's got a lot straighter, so he's bowling quicker, flatter. So definitely Kuldeep is a wicket taking option. Now I think it boils down to the team management. What are they looking? As I mentioned, someone like Axar gives them more control as a left arm orthodox finger spinner. But in terms of wicket taking, obviously Kuldeep is a better option in terms of wicket taking option. So I guess it boils down to the team management. What are they looking for? They're looking for control. Because what happens is if Axar can give them control, then Virat can use the other bowlers, the other three, Ashwin, Ishant and Bumrah, more attackingly in smaller or rather shorter spells. So I guess it just boils down to how or what they want from the spinner, the fourth spinner.
Okay. We've got another question. Now, this particular question has been asked many times, but we should touch upon it because it's sort of getting underlined now. When Neetu Jain is asking, why is Rohit Sharma getting failed to score big for so many innings?
Yeah, and you know, the thing is, he's looking good. It's not that he's out of form. I mean, remember Australia. I mean, all the test matches, all the innings, the 30s and the 20s that he got, he looked so good till the time he got out. He just looked so in form, in control, even in this test match. I mean, yeah, if first innings, that was a very, very good ball from Jofra Archer. Second, again, was a very good ball from Jack Leach. It was an absolute dream ball from Jack Leach. So it's not that he's out of form. He's out of runs. He's looking in form. It's just that he has to convert his starts. See, I can understand in a test match as an opener, you will get out early. The ball is harder, so it will be a little more difficult, more challenging to bat against the new ball. But I'm not too worried about the first test match because the two dismissals were against really good balls. But yes, I mean, in Australia, the starts he got and the way he was looking, he should have converted those. And to be very, very honest, I hope he does. I think he looked in form, he looked in control. I hope he converts those starts into a big one sometime soon.
Yeah, all our batsmen for that matter. We've got a question from Swamit Datta. Does Rishabh Pant need more patience when he's converting the three-digit mark?
Listen, Rishabh is Rishabh. He's going to play the way he knows how to play. And you don't expect anything else from him. The most important thing about players like Rishabh is shot selection, choosing the right ball, choosing the right shots. And if you look at how he's gone about in the last 6-odd months, you would see that he's improved with that. He's improved in selecting the right balls, the right shots. So he's improving, and that's what you want to see. If you expect him, see something like, you can't expect him to bat like, let's say, Cheteshwar Pujara, or vis-a-vis Cheteshwar Pujara batting like Rishabh. So I think, it's just the shot selection part, and it's good to see that he's improving every day.
And the matches, I've always been curious about this. When you're on the crease on the pitch and you've scored your century, what is the mentality then, and how do you calm yourself down? Because, you know, now right now we don't have an audience, but at that time there was an audience that was cheering you up. You know that you've done it. Your team is backing you. How do you calm yourself back down to sort of keep scoring? What goes on in a player's mind?
Obviously, I mean, it's filled with emotions. There's a lot of emotions. You're happy. At times, you're relieved. Depending on situation, there is every chance of you relaxing just a little bit. And that's where you see a lot of batsmen taking time after getting to that three-figure mark. So once you take time, you know, you try and collect all your thoughts. You try and calm yourself down, all the emotions down, and just focus. Try and get your focus back on the game, on your job as a batsman, and then you move on. So at times, I've done it. I know it because I've made that mistake of hurrying into getting back to batting again without calming myself, without getting my focus back. So you see a lot of batsmen, doing that. You see a lot of batsmen taking time after getting to that.
Okay. Well, I just have to tell all of you guys, somebody does not have a webcam. Somebody does not know how to connect. What are you guys doing? I wore makeup and wore a dress because I thought this was going to be a party here. You guys need to join, click on the StreamYard link and just join us here. And with that, we will move on to the next question. Now, Jay Patel, we've been waiting for you, but since you weren't able to join, I'm going to take your question. You've given it to me right here. Mr. Jay is asking, do you think India should have a rotation policy in place? For example, England rotating Anderson Broad. Anyone? I think we've dropped deep also. All right, so I'm the only one on the sports today chat right now. I'll just wait for Deep Sir, and anyone who is joining in, kindly join in, because if you don't know, yeah.
Sorry about that. Sorry,
no problem. We've got Jay Patel asking, do you think India should have a rotation policy in place? For example, England rotating Addison Broad. And this is the man who was on the video.
I mean, India, not officially, but it does kind of have a rotation policy, and they need to. If you look at the amount of cricket that is scheduled for the next year, and especially for all format players like someone like a Jasprit Bumrah, or and especially the bowlers I'm talking about. I think they will have to adapt to the rotation policy, and India at times have, for example, resting someone like Bumrah. I mean, if or batters who play all three formats, so. They would have to do that. But again, the situation is important. I mean, at this point in time, even if you were thinking of resting Bumrah in the second test match, you can't, right? Because obviously he's your premier fast bowler. And after losing the first test match, that option temporarily goes out of the window.
Yeah. All right. We've got Banani Datta. She's asking, in the Indian conditions, and of course, I saw that interview where... Joe Root said that India has a great history and a great record at home, but we're not scared. And clearly, they outdid us. So, Banani is asking in Indian conditions why India couldn't do well in the first innings of the match. And what areas should India improve before the second test? Should India improve on catching? Because England was superb in the field.
Yeah, I mean, catching is something that India hasn't done that well in the last series as well. Australia, India dropped a lot of catches. In fact, Australia dropped more than Indians. But India did drop a lot of catches. Here also, a few opportunities going down. It's definitely important for Indians to kind of hold on to all the chances or even half chances. That's one. Secondly, I think first things batting is going to be crucial again. I mean, we can, as we've discussed here on Sports Today, post match yesterday, first innings is so crucial. I mean, even first test match, if India had got a few more runs in the first innings, things would have been different, and I'm sure it was actually would have been different. I mean, first innings batting, and if you look at a few of them were unfortunate the way they got out. The starts, I mean, have to convert those starts. That's something that is very, very important. And I mean, someone like Pujara, I mean, that was unfortunate. Couldn't do much about that. Rishabh turned a little more. It should have been, again, that short selection. You know, maybe he needs to think about the execution. Virat got a start. Ajinkya, I mean, you know. It's not that they were beaten. So they were beaten by the ball, and there was a wonderful delivery to get out to, apart from, say, Rohit. Just get their heads together and just get that first innings going.
All right, first innings it is. We've got Tina Chhabra asking, what special did England do in this test match, sir? And they were phenomenal with their plans and execution.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I think it was a near-perfect test match for England. I mean, their planning-wise, execution was spot-on. Yes, I mean, Dom Best was a little up and down, maybe, even in the first innings after 13, 14 overs. Apart from that, I think they just got everything right. I mean, especially batting-wise. I mean, Dom Sibley has a role to play. He's almost in the mold of Pujara, what Pujara generally, I mean, he's the glue in that batting lineup. And then obviously Joe Root, I mean, he's in, I mean, the form of his life. Three back-to-back hundreds and three big hundreds. In the last four hundreds that he's got, three are double, and the other one's 186. And we all remember, I think 186 was a run out. So the form, obviously, Ben Stokes, Josh Butler is not available in this test match. So there'll be Ben Folkes coming in place of him. So, they were absolutely brilliant. And the key, again, was the first innings, the runs that they scored in the first innings, and also the discipline with which they bowled in both first and second innings. Jack Leach was very expensive as long as Rishabh was there. Once Rishabh got out, he was a different bowler. Second innings, he was absolutely brilliant. The first two wickets, they were close to unplayable deliveries, those two.
Okay, we've got Saurav Mandal asking an interesting question. He said, why doesn't BCCI use Kubura or Duke ball? As with the current ball, many players have had issues.
Yeah, it's always been SG test ball that's been used in test match cricket in India, even first class cricket in India. Kookaburra, I'm not too sure, because Kookaburra, the biggest issue or challenge with the Kookaburra is the seam. It's not as proud, and it dies down very, very quickly, especially on harder surfaces or abrasive surfaces like the one we saw in the first test. I don't know about Kookaburra, but yeah, the Dukes is very similar to SG in terms of the seam, in terms of the hardness. So Dukes is definitely an option. Dukes, which is generally, is used in England, English conditions. Dukes is a definite option. I'm not too sure about Kookaburra. But SG test as well, used to be very good. Even Virat mentioned it in the post-match. Ashwin mentioned it in the post-match. Maybe they should actually sit with the SG test people, the company, and figure this out, because it's such an important aspect.
Yeah. All right. With that, we've got a very first video caller who's going to be joining us. So Jeetu is helping us with our production on the back end. So Jeetu, let's get our very first video caller on air, if he's around. Or she's around. We've got Tina. My bad. Hello there. Hi, Tina.
Hi, sir. Good evening, sir. Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Ma'am,
please go for it.
Sir, I want to ask that what special we need to do to stop them to playing sweep? They are playing very, very well.
That was so evident, isn't it? Them sweeping our spinners and to great effect. I think, Tina, that's something that the Indian bowlers have to be very, very aware of. Ashwin bowled really well. They did not really sweep Ashwin that much in the first inning. Second inning, still they started sweeping Ashwin. But you know what happens? Someone like Aksar, if he comes into bowl, comes in and plays, one of the things that Aksar has is the ability to bowl fast. So when somebody's bowling flat and fast, look at Jadeja. He's such an important aspect, such an important cog in that wheel. Unfortunately, he's not available. But Aksar is bowling style is very similar to Jadeja. He's flatter, he's quicker. And what happens with that pace is it does not give the time for the batsman to kind of kneel down and sweep. And as a batsman, you're always wary of the fact that, someone like Aksar is quick. He can vary his length, and he can bowl the quick, fuller delivery, and fuller. It's difficult to sweep to half volleys. It's kind of very, very difficult. So I think, if someone like Aksar comes in, I think he has naturally that advantage with his pace and trajectory. Where it's going to be very difficult for the English batsman to sweep Aksar. And Ashwin, obviously, because he varies his pace so much. I'm sure all of you have noticed in the first test as well. He was varying his pace. Obviously, he was getting the ball to drift and dip as well. So, yeah, naturally, the kind of skill set that Ashwin has, it's that bit more difficult. And also Aksar, his skill set also would make it a little more difficult for the English batsman to sweep. But Tina, you're spot on. That's something that the Indian spinners will have to be very, very careful of.
Well, thank you so much, Tina, for joining our broadcast. And thank you for that lovely question. Next question, sir, is by a man called Tushar. He's joining us on the show. So, Tushar, you're welcome. Please feel free to join us. And there he is.
Hi, Riddhima. My question is... What's in store for Washington Sundar's test career in specifically? He is obviously selected as a bowling all-rounder or that kind of a role, but he's performing the opposite job pretty much. He's batting so well, but as a bowler, he's not quite standing out. So when Jadeja comes back, he's obviously not going to start. What's in store for him? And another question, how do you think India are going to approach making pitches from here on in this series? First one was obviously, I don't know what to make of it. The toss played such a big role. England won the toss and it was straight away 70-30 or 75-25. England batted well and the chances skyrocketed to say 80-20 or something along similar lines. So how do you think the test, pitch in second test in specific is going to be, and in Ahmedabad as well, in third and fourth test, including a pink ball test and a red ball one?
Yeah. Right.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Tushar. Thanks a lot for your question. So that's the pitch and Washington Sundar. Thank you.
Right. Tushar, thanks for joining in and for the question. Number one, I think Washington is more of a batsman who can bowl because that's what he's been doing all his career. If you look at his career, even for Tamil Nadu, he plays generally as a batsman who can bowl. And basically, the reason why he's playing is you need somebody to bat at number seven, an all-rounder to bat at number seven. So that's the role. And you rightly mentioned the fact that when Jadeja is back, he walks into that position. As far as his future, I think his future is very, very good. I mean, he was so comfortable in Australia. I mean, he's just playing his second test match. And somebody who hasn't played much first-class cricket, I think he's only played 12 first-class games before the Brisbane Test. And that to the last first-class was September 2017. So, you can straight away see the temperament, the mindset, and how good he is. And he's young. I think he's 21 or 22, maybe. So, obviously, he's got a very bright future. And according to me, he's an all-rounder. He's a batting all-rounder. Somebody who is a very good batsman and is improving as a bowler. And that's how it is, and that's how I see him going in the future as well. It's just that he has to start playing more first-class games. I think that's very, very important. So he gets more experience batting, more than batting, bowling with that red ball, right? So I think, bowling with the red ball, the skill sets are a little different from bowling with the white ball. So the more you bowl with it, you improve that side of your game. So that's one. Secondly, the pitches, I think, toss becomes important. There's no two ways about it. But India still, on day three, when India were batting, I think the pitch was still good enough to get more runs. But I would just like to see the pitches have a little more carry and pace. You know, a little more pace helps everyone. A little more bounce or pace. What happens is the spinners, the ball's turning quicker, the edges are carrying, same with the fast bowlers, the edges are carrying, and most important for the batsmen. If you've noticed, there weren't too many drives of the front foot. Not too many batsmen were able to play the drives because of the pace of the wicket. So if the ball's coming onto the bat, stroke play becomes easier. So you can drive the ball, you can cut and pull. So batting also becomes comparatively easier. You can play a lot more strokes. So the pace of the game also quickens. So, you know, in this test match, there were these slow moments in the game, right, where nothing was happening. Batsmen weren't scoring too many runs. The bowlers weren't picking up wickets. But once you have a quicker pitch, the pace of the game also quickens up. So I think what I would like to see from the second test match pitch, a little more bounce, a little more pace on the pitch. As far as Motera is concerned, I was looking at the Syed Mushtaq Ali Trophy games and I saw a lot of bounce and pace. So as long as there is bounce and pace, I think it helps everyone, whether you're a spinner, fast bowler or a batsman.
All right. I hope that answers your question, Tushar. You've got Ayush next. Ayush joining us on the show. Welcome, Ayush. You can join us whenever you're free. But I'm really loving this. This is great energy and I'm glad everybody...
It's a great idea, isn't it?
It's a superb idea. And even though people had difficulty to sort of tune in with the video, our comment section, sir, if you take a look at it, we have 120 unread questions right now. So while Ayush quickly joins us, let me ask you another question. We've got Rishikesh Kodale saying, I'm a big fan of you, Deep sir, to begin with. And should India consider changing its test captain if India loses the series?
Oh, well, again, thank you so much. I really appreciate all the compliment, and I hope I keep entertaining all of you. Well, there will be questions asked. Let's be very, very honest about this, especially after what happened in Australia. And there will be questions and what happened in the first test. So if something happens in this test series, and India, obviously, if something wrong happens or it doesn't go in India's favor, India will obviously not qualify then for the World Test Championship. And then you have five test matches in England. I think as of now, I don't think we need to address that question, but that question is already there. Let's not think that it is not there. That question is there. People are thinking about that. A lot of people are thinking about that, but I think maybe this is not the right time. Maybe after that England series, India in England, if India does not qualify for the World Test Championship, that would obviously mean India hasn't done that well in this test series. And then the series in England, I think maybe we can address that question then. But I know a lot of people are asking that question now. As well. So all I'm going to say is just hold on to it for a while. Let's see how the Indian team performs in the next few test matches. And then maybe around July, August, we can revisit.
Okay. All right, so last question for the day. And last, you're joining us. You've got Ayush joining us. So Ayush, if you're around, just hop in, man. Just hop in, join the party. And let's have you here. I think he's taking a bit of a time to switch on his camera, put on makeup. He wants to look good for the show. Ayush, where are you? All right, by the time Ayush joins us, let's move on to the next question. Harish is like, is bad habit of bowling bowling no ball nets hurting India? And Indian fielding varies right from Australia. We've addressed the fielding issue, but how about no balls?
Yeah, no balls are a big worry. If you look at the number of no balls, that was a shocker. Obviously, now that the no balls gone to the third umpire, so even the marginal calls. Now how many balls. Bowlers were overstepping before as well. You get a fair idea. So just they have to improve. Irrespective, that's a huge, I think about 27 no balls, 28 no balls, something like that, which is huge. 26 is the number, right? So 26 no balls. So that is huge. I mean, that's something that as a group, because it's not that one bowler bowled the no balls. I mean, even someone like Ashwin, who generally doesn't bowl no balls, I think this is his 75th test. He hasn't bowled a no ball before this test match. He hasn't. And this test match, I think he's bowled four or five no balls. Right, so obviously, there is something. So I think this needs to be addressed by the bowling unit as a group, because everyone's bowled no balls in this test match, and maybe maybe trying to put in that extra effort, because yes, this was a slowish track, right? So as a bowler, you had to put more effort into it, more body into it, and while doing that, obviously there is a possibility of you overstepping. So maybe that could be the reason. But, there's a lot of experience in that dressing room in terms of bowlers. You have someone like Ashwin, you have Ishant, you have Bumrah. So there is a lot of experience there, and obviously the bowling coaches. They need to address this.
All righty. I think we've answered a fair deal of questions today. And I'd just like to thank you, sir, for joining us on the show. And taking our time. I know you're in Chennai, you're very, very busy there. Also, to a big thank you to all our viewers for tuning in, for all your questions. And we're going to be back with Pragyan tomorrow. And we're going to do a very similar session. So hopefully your webcams will work and your makeup is in place so that you guys come and hop in quickly. Thank you so much for joining in. And of course, see you tomorrow. Same time, same place. And of course, do remember to subscribe and like our channel.